Canada advises its citizens about the elevated level of violent crime in Trinidad and Tobago. The Government of Canada has recently issued a travel advisory urging potential visitors to Trinidad and Tobago, TNT, to exercise extreme caution due to the prevalence of violent crime in the region. According to the official website of the Government of Canada, travel.gc.ca, updated on March 28, violent crime, including armed robberies, assaults, and sexual assaults, is alarmingly frequent, particularly in the capital city of Port of Spain. The advisory explicitly warns that tourists have been targeted in these incidents. Furthermore, the advisory notes a concerning rise in kidnapping for ransom since 2018, with cruise ship passengers advised to exercise extreme caution while navigating around the docks in Port of Spain. Gang and drug-related violence, including shootings and kidnappings, pose significant risks, with visitors cautioned to avoid certain areas altogether. Petty crimes like pickpocketing, bag snatching, and thefts from cars are also prevalent. Specifically, the advisory lists areas such as Laventil, Beetham Gardens, Sea Lots, Cocorite, Carenage, Morvant, Savannah Park, Fort George, La Brea, Pitch Lake, and Las Cuevas Beach as high-risk zones. It strongly advises against traveling outside Port of Spain after dark, particularly along the Beetham Highway. The advisory further underscores the threat of home invasions, cautioning that these incidents can turn violent. It recommends remaining vigilant at all times, especially by ensuring that accommodations are securely locked. Additionally, the advisory mentions the terrorism threat to potential visitors, emphasizing the need for heightened awareness. Regarding the island of Tobago, the advisory notes similar concerns about violent crime, including assaults, sexual assaults, and armed robberies. It reiterates that incidents against foreigners, including Canadians, have occurred, with petty crimes also being reported. Attempts to reach out to Minister of Foreign and CARICOM Affairs Dr. Amory Brown for comment on the advisory, but no response was received.